So to understand how it preserves edges while smoothing the images, consider this example. So assume this, we have an edge over here and the pixel is on the left side of this edge. So we have pixel over here and we can form the quadrants. So this is our red region and assume that this is our yellow region. So we can see that this pixel will either take the mean of this quadrant or this quadrant, because these two quadrants are going to have lesser variance as compared to the variance of this region or the variance of this region. So since the pixel is on this side of the edge, we see that the Kuwara filter will actually assign the mean of either quadrant 1 or quadrant 2 rather than assigning the value of quadrant 3 or quadrant 4, which will have much higher variance. Similarly, consider an example over here where the pixel on this side. So we have four quadrants assigned. And now we can see that on this side, Kuwara filter will either assign this value, the mean, or this mean. And we can see that this is going to be of higher variance as compared to this region. So Kuwara filter will assign the mean of this region to this pixel when it is on this side of the edge. And if the pixel happens to be exactly on the edge, then Kuwara filter will go with a region that has minimum variance. So basically, this ensures that the edges are preserved and the mean results. So when we consider only pixels in this region for filtering, we are effectively performing operations similar to what the bilateral filter did. Bilateral filter assigned higher value to the pixels that are closer in the color space. And here also we can see that the Kuwara filter is roughly performing the same operation, although in a totally different computational manner. So when we select only the pixel of this region to compute the average value of this pixel, we are effectively blurring and we are also preserving edge by not taking these pixels into account while computing the transform value for this pixel. And if the pixel happens to be on the edge, the Kuwara filter will go with either one of the blocks that have minimum variance. So the image is smoothed as a result of blurring due to the mean, the average filter, and it's going to preserve edges because of the selection of only pixels that are sort of more homogeneous in nature for computing the mean value. So effectively in textured regions, the Kuwara filter will reduce the texture, and in noisy regions, it will just work as a uniform filter but with edge preservation. So again, Kuwara filter is applied in an iterative fashion, pixel by pixel. So we'll have two nested for loops where the transformed pixel values would be given by m k, where k is arg min over j, sigma square j for j equal to 1 to 4 for the four quadrants. Here we can write mkij to denote the that this mean is computed around the regions, around one of the quadrants of pixel I, j. So the operation we have just discussed, it works well for the grayscale images, but one of the questions is, how are we going to implement it in color images? So one of the naive ways that you can think of is, perhaps, okay, why not divide an RGB image into red channel, green channel and blue channel and separately apply Kovara filter. But consider a particular pixel assume it has consider the four quadrants around it. Now it may be the case that if we use red, green and blue channel independently and operate on those channels independently, then it may be a case that perhaps the red channel goes with this quadrant, blue channel goes with this quadrant and green channel goes with this quadrant. So you see, it would because of the selection of different quadrants in different color spaces, it may result in the distortion of the colors for many of the pixels. So how can we come up with a strategy of selecting a common quadrant for all the color channels? So basically we again apply the Kovara filter independently to each of the channels, but we ensure that each of those channels selects the same quadrant for every pixel. And we do that by converting our RGB color image. So we first convert the RGB image into an HSV image, which we can do with any standard library. I mean, for example, OpenCV or any other image processing computation library would have a regular conversion for RGB to HSV. And if not, then there's a formula, there's an analytical solution for computing the HSV image from an RGB image. It is irrelevant for this discussion, so we'll not discuss it. So we convert the RGB image into an HSV image, and then we compute the quadrants in the V space. So we use the V channel of HSV color space to get the quadrants. And then once the quadrant is selected, we then apply the Kovara filter to each of the channels RGB at that location. So to apply the Kovara filter to color images, we convert the image. So that's step number one. Convert RGB image to HSV image. Discard the HS end component and just focus on the V component. So we take the V component, the intensity component. Then we compute for all pixel I, j, we compute the quadrant using the V channel. Then we just apply the Kovara filter to the R channel. So this is red channel of the resultant image. Takes the M K, where K we got from the V channel. M K. And superscript R to show that this is a mean of the quadrant, particular quadrant that we obtain from V channel for the red channel. Similarly, the resultant green channel value would be the mean of the quadrant in green channel, and then the blue channel will take the mean value of the same quadrant in the blue channel. So this is how we apply Kovara filter for color images. And if we don't perform this operation, for example, if we just select the quadrant independently for the channels, then this is going to be distorting the colors in the resultant image. So this ends our discussion of the Kovara filter, and next we'll consider an example to show the difference between the Kovara and the bilateral filter.